CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello children, how are you? Hope you are doing well. I am Professor Kirti Kapoor from NCERT, New Delhi. Today I am going to take up a poem with you, The Kite. This poem is from NCERT's English textbook for class 6, Honeysuckle and Unit 2. Okay, before I take up the poem, I want to know, have you ever tried to fly a kite? I am sure you must have, and you must have enjoyed also. Was it fun? Yes, it's always a fun. All of us like to fly kites. Now, poetry has a musical quality. When we read a poem, it's different from a prose lesson. It has a musical quality. It has rhythm, pitch, meter, and it uses many figures of speech, such as simile, metaphor, etc. So these are some of the things you have to keep in mind while reading a poem. And poems are meant to be read aloud with proper tone, intonation, stress. Okay, I will read the poem for you, then you will understand what I mean by all of this. Now, the moment we hear the word kite, what words come to your mind? Words related to kite. So I am going to give you 1 minute to note down those words. You can share or discuss with your friends. That is better. Have you jotted down the words? I have also jotted down a few words. Shall I share my words with you? The moment we hear the word kite, the words that come to my mind are the word itself, kite. Diamond shape. The shape of the kite is diamond shape. Tail. It has a tail. Then string. We cannot fly a kite without a string. Spool. Spool is where the string is rolled. Wind. Yes, without wind, no kite flying. Open space. We need open ground to fly the kite. Terrace. Some people fly kite on the terrace also because they get height. But one has to be very careful. Don't go alone to the terrace. Either go with your parents or somebody who is elder to you. One has to be careful. Then park. Sometimes we go to the parks to fly kite. Beach. There are many people who fly kites on the beach. Those who live near the beach, they find that place very easy. Colorful. Kites are of different colors. Red, green, blue, yellow. Fun. It's always a very interesting, very enjoyable to fly kites. Then friends. So we are in the company of friends when we fly the kite. Then breeze. We require breeze to take it high. From high to higher. Then it rises up till the sky. It is a, what is it? It's a toy. Right? Kite is a toy. So these are some of the words I have noted down when I hear the word kite. Now with the help of these words, you can write a few sentences also. Try writing it. Okay? Now, when we are talking about kites, there are many verbs also associated with it. Verbs are action words, which show us the action of the noun, action of the person or object, right? Now, this kite, what are the verbs that are associated with it? Action words. Soars. Soars means goes up. So, this is an action word. It rides. Where does it ride? It rides on the breeze. It climbs. It goes up. It pulls. Falls. Snaps. Flaps. Dives. Dips. Dives comes down. Dips. Blows. Flies. Steers. Holds. And again goes up. So these are some of the movements of the kite. So have you noted down these words also? So with the help of the words that we have written associated with the kite, and also the action words that we have written associated with the word kite, we can write a paragraph. Would you like to write a paragraph before I read a poem? You can write this paragraph when the session is over, and you can share it with the teacher and with your friends. Now, may I ask a few questions to you? What time of the year do you fly kites? What time of the year? You know, generally, kite flying is associated with festivals, harvesting festivals. So at that time, it comes around New Year, January, February, and the weather is also clear, the sun also doesn't hurt us much, and people fly kites. So when you fly kites, do you make your own kite or you buy the kites? I will tell you how to make a kite. At the end of the poem, I will share the steps with you to make a kite. Next time, when you want to fly a kite, make your own kite. It's a beautiful craft. From where do you fly the kite? The ground or the terrace? I think ground is better. If you fly the kite from the terrace, then better be careful. Okay, don't go there alone. Make sure that your parents or elders are with you. What precautions do you take? We have to be very careful. We should not trip, because the string of the kite is also very stiff. It can also hurt us. So these are some of the things we have to keep in mind. Now, I will read the poem for you. Listen to the poem carefully. Get the image through the words in front of your eyes, and you will understand the meaning of the poem. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. How bright on the blue. Now, blue is here, sky. On the blue is a kite when it is new. With a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail, then soars like a ship with only a sail, as over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. When string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows. With its wings fill up it goes. How bright on the blue is a kite when it is new. But a raggeder thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. Now, the poet Harry Benn has written this poem. Harry Benn has written many poems for children. He writes for children. He has written novels, poems. He is a great writer. So in this poem, he has really described the flying of the kite. It looks bright against the blue sky, especially when it is brand new. Isn't it beautiful to see that? Do you like that? When your kite is new and it is flying high up in the blue sky, it dives and a dip. First it goes down and then it slowly goes down and picks up and goes up and up and up and up and soars like a ship. It goes up and soars like a ship goes on the waves. You know, kite doesn't go up in one go. It goes up, comes down, goes up, comes down like a ship on the waves. And it seems as if it is riding on the wind. It climbs to the crest of the gust and pulls. That, you know, breezy wind is taking it up. Then the string goes slack and suddenly if there is no wind, it starts becoming little loose. And what do you do at that time? You quickly start rolling the string. And you wait for the next breeze to come. Once again, the kite fills its wings with air, with new breeze, and goes up and up and up. It looks so beautiful against the blue sky. And especially when it is brand new, but a raggeder thing you never will see. And when it tears and falls down, would you like to see it? No, probably not, because it's of no use anymore when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree, when it is flapping stuck in the top of a tree. I think this is what we experience while flying a kite. Do you also experience the same thing? Yes, I am sure you must have. Now let us look at the words that the poet has used in this poem to create that image in front of our eyes. Dive and dip. How the dive has a greater movement to go down, while dip means a shallow downward movement. That means it doesn't go down quickly. It just slowly goes down. Soars and rides. It soars up and then goes up along with the wind. Climb and pull. It goes up and you keep pulling it. The poet has used the figure of speech simile in this poem. Now, what is a simile? Simile is an obvious comparison, obvious, and it is characterized by the use of as or like. When a simile is used, the writer or we should use the word as to compare it with the other object, or we should use the word like. Each simile creates a very vivid picture of what the poet is describing. So let us look at a few examples that the poet has given. The kite soars like a ship, right? The poet has compared the kite to a ship. Now, can we have more examples beyond the poem? Can we have more examples? Yes, why not? The leopard moves like a light. The leopard moves like a light. She sings like an angel. Her eyes shone like diamonds. I felt like a fish out of water. The clown was as tall as a tree. She is as busy as a bee. Now can I give you a few blanks to fill with, you know, that the things that you can compare with? He runs like dash. You can create your own comparisons. It is not necessary that you have to give examples of those examples. You have to give examples which are written in the textbook. You can create your own examples also. He runs like a deer. Or he runs like a leopard. That means he is very fast. Okay, the next. He eats like dash. Do you want to compare with something that is around you? You can. I will give you my answer. He eats like a horse. Generally, we say he eats like a pig. She sings like dash. She sings like a canary, or we can say she sings like a nightingale, or you can compare it this one with your friend. Okay? It shines like dash. It shines like a diamond. It shines like a star. It flies like dash. It flies like a bird. Or you can also write the word kite. It flies like a kite. Now I am going to share the steps of making a kite with you. Pay attention. And then after listening to this, I am sure you will be able to make a kite for yourself. Making a simple diamond kite is an easy craft. It's a craft. It is fun to make a simple diamond shaped kite. Now the items that you will need to make a kite, jot down the list that I am sharing with you. You will require paper. If you have newspaper, you can make it with that. If you want to have a colored paper, you can have that also. Paper, then you need sticks also to make the frame of the kite. Then you need glue, then thread, scissors, colored pencils, tape, ruler, decorative items. If I have missed out on anything, you please add to the list. I will say the words again. Okay? Please write down when I am speaking these words. Paper, sticks, glue, thread, scissors, colored pencils, tape, ruler, decorative items. Clear? Let us now listen to the steps. Start by making the frame for the kite. Those sticks that you have, okay? You have to make the frame by pasting them together and then tying them with the thread. Then measure and cut the sail for the kite in the shape of a diamond. Have you made the frame? Then you measure the frame and cut the sail for the kite in the shape of a diamond. Finish up the kite by adding the tail. Now you stick this together with the help of the glue or with the help of the tape. You can also decorate the kite when it is done so it looks extra pretty as it soars in the air. You can put a few stars on it or you can draw on it. So you can put some decorative items on the kite to make it look prettier. Will you be able to make your own kite now? I am sure you will be able to make it. Rather, you already know how to make a kite if you fly one. Now I have a little writing task for you. Write a paragraph describing the process of making a kite. Okay? How did you make your kite? Now that you are going to make one? So please write down the entire process into a paragraph so that anybody who reads it should be able to make a kite. As I told you, the poet Harry Benn has written many poems for children. I have brought 4 lines of his another poem, Trees. I'll just read these lines for you to enjoy. Okay, listen and enjoy. Trees are the kindest things I know. Trees are the kindest things I know. They do no harm. They simply grow and spread a shade for sleepy cows and gather birds among their boughs. How beautiful. If you want to read more poems by Harry Benn, you can find them when you go to your school, ask your teacher to give you more poems to read. Now, would you like to create a poem of your own? You have learnt about adjectives, you know action words are verbs, you know what a noun is. So, we will now talk about a cinquain poem. A cinquain poem is a 5-line poem. This poem is also in the shape of a diamond. You take a word, a noun, first line. First line, noun. I have taken the word kite. Okay. Now in the second line, I will write 2 adjectives about the kite. While I am speaking, you can also follow the same process and write a cinquain poem. You can take any object or you can write this cinquain poem about yourself. You can write your name. Now in the second line, write down 2 adjectives about the noun that you have written. Since I have written kite, so the 2 adjectives are light, bright. Okay? Then in the third line, I will write 3 action words like flying, soaring, dipping. Then in the fourth line, a phrase or any 2 adverbs. I have written the phrase right on the breeze. And the last line, the synonym of the word that you have chosen as noun. I have chosen the word kite and I have given the synonym diamond to it because its shape is like a diamond. So, I have created a cinquain poem. I will read it for you once again. Kite, bright, light, flying, soaring, dipping, rides on the breeze, diamond. I am sure you have been able to create your own cinquain poem. With this, we have come to the end of this session. I hope you enjoyed listening to the poem, The Kite.
Children, listen to the poem called A Kite. Our young friend will recite the same poem.
A kite. I often sit and wish that I could be a kite up in the sky and ride upon the breeze and go whichever way I chance to blow.
A kite. I often sit and wish that I could be a kite up in the sky and ride upon the breeze and go whichever way I chanced to blow. And now, listen to the magic of music, which will make this poem come alive. All right?
Yeah!
Now let's listen to the tune or melody that we have set for this poem. It's being played on the piano and the drums. Now children, we are going to hum along but not hmm, but roo 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 roo. Ready?
Much for being with us. Happy learning. Wish you all the best.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This series was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.